Hello, my name is Juan Segovia, and I'm a homicide detective with the Miami-Dade Police Department. On Tuesday, November the 6th of 2006, Brian Pata, star football player for the University of Miami, was driving home and pulled into his apartment complex when he was approached by an unknown suspect and shot. Uniform units from the Miami-Dade Police Department Kendall District, as well as Miami-Dade Fire Rescue, responded to the scene, and despite all life-saving efforts, they were unable to save Brian Pata's life, and he died on scene as a result of his injuries. Brian Pata was a young man who was not only a local high school football hero, but he was also a very good player and a very well-known player at the University of Miami. One of the challenges of investigating a case like this with a victim like Brian Pata is that Brian Pata, his whole world revolved around football and his family. So it's not like he had a lot of enemies. He wasn't involved in any criminal element. He's a young man who was looking forward to a future in the NFL. That's all he wanted to do, play football in the National Football League. He wanted to take care of his family one day. He wanted to take care of his mom, sisters, and his brothers. And that's all he ever talked about, and that's all he ever aspired to do in his life. There's no greater loss that a human being can experience in their life than the loss of their own child. And I think for Brian, that was multiplied over and over again because he was so close to his brothers and sisters and his family that I think they felt that for the last 15 years that there was no resolution to the case. This investigation was somewhat a lengthy investigation. One of the unique things about homicides is that there's no statute of limitation for a homicide. It's the highest crime in the land. And for us, we always say it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. And for us, it's about getting it right. I'm very blessed to work in what I believe is the best homicide unit in the country, if not the world. The men and women that worked this case from day one for the last 15 years are the best of the best. I can tell you that we could have never done it, not only this case, but many of the cases we work, without the community's help. This may be because Brian was so loved by so many of his teammates and he had so much family and extended family that not only did the family never give up, not only did the family never stop fighting to find out who killed Brian Pata, but the community never stopped contacting us. And even if we get 1,000 tips, but only one of them was the one that actually put the pieces together, that's what it took, and that's exactly what happened in this case. As a result of 15 years of investigation, countless hours, numerous interviews, and incredible work done by countless detectives, with the assistance and collaboration of the state attorney's office, we were able to obtain an arrest warrant charging Rashawn Jones with first-degree murder. As a result of that warrant being signed, the U.S. Marshals Service were able to locate Rashawn Jones and take him into custody, and he was subsequently arrested for a first-degree murder, and he is now awaiting extradition back to Miami-Dade County for prosecution. I can only hope that this brings the Pata family a little bit of closure, a little bit of satisfaction, knowing that at least the person who took Brian's life is now in custody and will be facing charges. I want to thank the Pata family as well, because it's been 15 years of waiting, 15 years of missing Brian, 15 years of waiting for results, of being told constantly to be patient, to have faith in the system, to have faith in the process, and you had faith in us, and you stuck with us, and you fought with us the whole way. And together, not only between the Pata family, Miami-Dade Police Department Homicide Bureau, and the Miami-Dade Police Department, but as well as the community, we all came together, and the final result is one that I hope can bring you a little bit of peace and a little bit of closure.